Hey, today I want to give you a little tour of our van here. You can see from the outside, it's nicely painted. There are mountains on it and some waves. Actually, my mother did it. She's a really good painter. We just took usual car paint, and on the other side, we have some trees. This is our shower here. I can just take it off, fill it up with water. Then we hang it here, so the water gets warm over the day. And then we can just shower here. I have to get down a little because it's not high enough, but works pretty well. Let's go inside. Let's first turn up the light. We have the main light up here. Then we have a dimmer back here. And in the bed, we have another light over here and a light here. That's way too much. When we built this van, I thought light is really important, but you don't need that much. This is our kitchen. We have running water over here, so we can do the dishes. It's super easy. We just got fresh water and old water. Inside there's just this little water pump. And if we open this, water comes out. We got some additional water in the back, so we got 60 liters. This one holds 20. And here's our cooking station. We can cook everything, coffee and hot meals. There we have our drawers, the cutlery up here. Here we got some plates and cups, and down here there's the trash, and we always try to separate it. This is plastic and all the rest, glass and paper we put in the back, and there are some more accessories to clean the van. We got all these drawers from a broken RV from the trash yard, so they got these locks so they can come out when we are driving. These are our spices. It looks really cool, but I rarely use them because we don't cook that big of a meal where you really need all of them, but salt is important. Up here we got some cosmetics, sunscreen and soaps. We always use eco-friendly soap so that it's compatible with use in nature. Usually the fridge was up here and we could draw it out, but it broke off like 3 days ago. And now I just placed it on the floor. We can store everything fresh inside. And it works pretty good. It runs on 12 volts, so it don't draw that much battery. The toilet is out here. It was underneath the fridge before. We don't use it that often. I try to go outside, but if we are in a town, we can use that. These are the windows. You can open this and open the window here and then put a mosquito net. This is our dining table slash workspace. We have this seat. You can even sit here while driving. You have the security. I put some screws from underneath the car, so it's safe. I also have to get registration for out. I didn't yet, but I will do it. And here you can also sit. And underneath this, we have some more storage. We got the water bottles and some blankets. Up here is another box where we just put some more food and some kitchen accessories that don't fit in there. Inside this box, we store all the food. And you actually can take it away, and then you can see all the surfboards underneath. I will show you the surfboards later. And in here is all the electric. We got two batteries. I have an inverter so that I can power my laptop, and all the other safety features. We can store a lot of stuff behind this one. The electronic goes from this box everywhere in the van. We have a little power station here where you can charge a phone. Down there are some chargers for the laptop. Over here I get some more light switches, and also we can use the kitchen machine. That's the main board for all the electricity. I can turn it off here. That's the inverter to charge my laptop. Here we got the control for our heater so that we can stay in the van during the winter. And this little guy warns us when there is gas in the van. This is our cozy little bed. We got this window to check the waves when you're still half asleep. Down here we can store all our clothes. This is just that nothing comes out. And over here I got some charging equipment. There are a lot of cables. I totally lost control. Maybe I have to clean it up someday. There is the second bed up here, and we can put it down if a third person wants to sleep in the van. The best thing about this van, I can just prepare the coffee in the evening and then just reach out of bed, start it, sleep for another 5 minutes and wake up to fresh coffee. Here I store my laptop and all the charged batteries. Here I got some more camera equipment and all the GoPros. And down here I got the big camera bag with the gimbal and all that stuff. We even have some storage underneath here. I will show you. You can open it up here. This is our gas box. We have two bottles of gas here. And if there's a leak inside this box, the gas will flow through the floor and nothing will happen on the outside. It's also the standard you have to use when having gas in a van. This is my kitesurf equipment. I never use it because I usually go surfing, but I just have it in case there is some wind. Here we got all the surfboards, some additional water and some wetsuits. These are all the boards in order. Longboard, soft top and two short boards. And they all fit in there. Inside the box we have boat paint, so the water won't get through, so I can put all the wet wetsuits. We can draw this out, so we got some additional space. Here I have all the boxes, there are drone equipment, surf stuff, additional food and these things. And like this I can easily reach this box and then just put it back in. We bought that van 1 year ago and we thought that the conversion would take us 3 weeks, but in the end it took us 4 months to convert it. We had a lot of rust, the inside took a long time, and we also went way over budget. We planned with 6,000 euros in total. In the end, we paid 13,000 for the van and the whole conversion. We even got some parts from a broken RV from the trash yard, but still, for us it was really expensive. Yeah, was fun and I learned a lot. That was the full room tour. I have a lot of videos where I do adventures with this van, so don't forget to subscribe to the channel and thanks for watching.